Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. We're gonna do a product segment and I guarantee you some of these products will take your home renovation project to that next level. So first off, let's start with the fluid faucet. Now it's a beautiful faucet, aside from that, because that's not why I want to show it. It's a nice looking faucet. What I love about it is when you look at the aerator underneath where the water comes out, this portion is adjustable. So you can see you can pivot that. Why is that important? Well, when you have a basin that's shaped a certain way at the bottom, sometimes different faucets have different water flows and the direction of water flow doesn't coincide well with that basin. So when it hits the bottom of the basin, you get some splashing and it's not great. The fact that you can adjust it really is a great solution for that problem. So you can adjust that so that that water hits the basin in the right way. You don't get any splashing and everything is great. I love that. Now, Watco has a product that I wanted to show because with regards to that basin, sometimes that drain at the bottom is a problem aesthetically. Now, in a bedroom setting or an ensuite setting, when you've got a bathroom and the pop-up is there and the faucet accommodates that, that's okay, but in a powder room, sometimes I don't like to see that pop up. And in the past, we've even gone as far as using commercial drains where it just has that grate on top and the pop up is non-existent. And then we leave the pop up lever out and that's it. But if you wanna utilize that pop up lever, but still have a very clean look at the bottom, this is your solution. So this is a drain that has that beautiful grate on top, but when you pop this off, inside is the pop-up. So it's actually hidden inside the drain body. So the pop-up still works, seals the water when you need it to, but it's got this nice clean finish on the drain. So in regards to powder room settings, when you want a clean finish, this is your solution. Now, when it comes to bathtubs, there's a problem because over time, over the years, you get some corrosion in that drain and it starts to look like this. Right here on the picture, you can see that it starts to corrode, and I know that some of you guys may relate to this. What do you do? Well, it's difficult to pull it out. It's a challenge to pull it out. When you start pulling that out and unscrew that thing, get a new one in, it can be a nightmare. Well, a simple solution from Watco again is this here. It's actually this thin ring of metal right here that gets put down with this adhesive they supply. Once it's set, you have this beautiful finished look with a built-in pop-up right here and a stopper that pushes down. It's got some friction to it and it stays down, plugs the water, and then you can open it to drain it. Comes in a few different finishes. You've got a oil rub bronze here, brushed nickel, and these two here, but these three all have different functions. So this one here has that friction fit that goes up and down. This one here is the old pop-up where you push it down and it locks, and then you push it again and it opens. And then this one here is more of a mechanical operation where you lift it up and turn it and it stays up, and then you turn it again and it drops down. So these are great solutions, a great way to make that unsightly drain look good. Next up, let's talk about water leaks. I want to talk about this contraption. Now, water has a language, believe it or not. So every time you turn your faucet on, it has a certain signature how water flows through that faucet. Well, the fin not only learns those signatures so it knows which faucets you're turning on, it also monitors what's happening in your water system hundreds of times per second. So this guy here actually connects to your inlet line coming into the house. Now they've got a smaller unit that's a localized unit that you may put under a sink so you can use it in condos and places like that. But now you're able to monitor your water system in your home on many different levels. So how it works, it actually monitors everything from the pressure in the lines, the water flow, the temperature, multiple times a second, and it knows what's going on. So not only does it know what faucet you're turning on, it records when you're turning it on, how much water you're using. So it gives you those metrics of your water usage, but also is able to detect problems. So if you have a sudden drop in pressure that it does not recognize, well, it'll send you an email and it will say, I sense a potential damage happening or a problem happening, and if I don't hear from you within the next 30 seconds, I'm shutting the water down. Or if it senses pressure building up in the pipes, it will anticipate that there's water freezing and building pressure in the pipes, and it's imminently gonna blow, so it will automatically shut the water down to prevent excessive damage. This thing is brilliant. Like I said, there's several versions that you can get. Once you learn how to use it and get really connected connected with that app. There's so many benefits to having this. And then knowing that when you're away from home, you can control the water in the house, shut it off. If you're away for an extended period of time, you can shut it off. You can turn it on. If someone was going to the house to do any service, there's so much you can do. I love it. It's a great product. Next, we're gonna talk about electrical. So we'll put some of these plumbing things aside. Some of the components with regards to electrical, I mean, there's so many, but I brought a few that we've used for many, many years. From an aesthetic purpose, they're great. So Evoline has a product called the Port. And normally on a countertop, all you would see is this ring showing. You drill a 4-inch hole in the countertop and you put this thing in and it connects from underneath and it's got a little indent right here. So when you push that indent, it toggles up. So when you grab that and you pull it, out comes your port. Now what's on the port? Multiple receptacles, couple of USB outlets. You can actually customize the configuration of this, comes in different finishes. And then when you no longer need these, you push it down and it's concealed inside your cabinetry. The cord is below, plugs into an outlet below inside the cabinets. It's a great way to have receptacles on an island. Instead of putting them in plain view on the ends or in the cabinetry, this is a great way to have them right at hand. Lift it up, plug things in, do your work. When you don't need them, close it. And it tucks away, it looks beautiful. They've got another unit that actually addresses some of the concerns today. We've got wireless chargers, where do you put them? This is a really simple way to integrate that into a countertop or a side table. It's visible on top, you've got this panel that slides open, and when it slides open, you've got a receptacle, some USB outlets, and then when it closes, this top is a wireless charger. So all you do is lay your cell phone on top and it will wirelessly charge. Some great innovative products here. And then lastly, I want to talk about the washer and dryer. Well, actually dryer in particular. When it comes to that dryer, there's a couple of problems. One of the problems is, how do you push that thing right to the wall so that you don't have that gap in the back where socks and laundry falls into and then you can't get to it? And then secondly, when you get that thing first connected, how do you ensure that that pipe is connected securely? It doesn't come loose, it doesn't tear, doesn't have a whole bunch of snaky winds in it that really restrict the flow, and then that way you get the best out of your dryer and all that air, all that moist air is vented right out of the house. Well, a couple of ways. Number one, we've got the mag vent. Love this thing. I picked this up from Lee Valley Tools in Oakville, Burlington actually, and this is a great product. Why? Because let me pull this apart, we'll start. You set this up on the wall and it's connected to your dryer vent pipe, so it goes out of the house. This side connects to your dryer. So you've got this flexible pipe, it connects to the dryer. And if you line these up properly with a few measurements, you can get that one perfect. When you slide that dryer in and it gets close, that connects and you get 100% seal. You don't have to worry about any leakage. And then if you have to service it, it pulls apart easily. You pull it forward, you release this, you do your servicing and put it back together again. I love that, that's so innovative. And then lastly, one of the ways we push the dryer right back to the wall is by using the dryer box. Almost a no-brainer. Every project we do has a dryer box. So behind the dryer, we know roughly where the dryer vent is gonna go. We position this between the studs, and it's got two holes in it. One hole for a pipe, and a knockout also for a gas line. So if you have a gas dryer, the gas line would come in here, gas line would connect here, and the dryer hose or the vent pipe would connect here. Now, what's great about this is that it gives you that cavity inside the wall so that when you push that dryer in, all that excess pipe bunches up in here, connects up, and you get a nice direct flow, whether you want it to go up or down, doesn't matter, you install it the way that you want. When it's finished, the drywall sets right off the sides, you've got a nice clean finish, nice caulking line, it looks great, and it allows you to push that dryer right to the wall so you no longer have that gap in the back. So that's it for this segment. I hope you liked it. And if you did, make sure you hit that like button. If you think some of your friends might like some of these products, make sure you share this video and subscribe because you're gonna wanna stay connected to my channel. I got so many more of these coming. I'll see you on the next one.